Winning. That's what it
Correct.
says. Oh, he's back, I think.
He's back here.
Santosh, are you back?
Maybe we can type the message. Not able to hear him.
Hello, can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Now we can hear you,
Yeah.
Santosh.
Yeah.
Okay, so header details, we have seen the header details such as sales organization data we need to enter, and we need to enter the purchase organization details, settlement data, business volume data. So business volume data is, it plays a significant role while determining the settlement for that particular contract. So that's why if you miss the business volume data to enter here or to maintain here, it will not determine the condition contract at a sales transaction, and it will not also determine at a settlement. So that's why this is a mandatory field, or this is a mandatory option. Okay, and the eligible partners. So who are all the eligible partners for this condition contract? You can maintain the eligible partners here. Say for example, I have this customer and this is eligible partner. Not only this customer, if this partner is eligible for this business partner is eligible as supplier or as a retailer or as a carrier. So all these things we can enter here, all the customers or all the partners we can enter here. Okay, so here we will see the interval. This is basically the interval of your header data. So here by this, what we are saying is this customer is eligible to use this condition contract, okay, within this period. So it can be within the range of the header data. So like for example, I have created the header contract from 16/6/2018 till 30/6/2018, but this customer is eligible only for 10 days. So you can also maintain this customer only valid for 10 days. So after this 10 days is over, even if you create any transaction, this condition as a rebate settlement is not eligible for this. So this is a place where we are saying the system, okay, these are the list of customers which are relevant. Okay, so and at a VBox is a table which shows what are all my relevant billing documents for a rebate. But here only the customer and his validity will talk about the relevancy towards the settlement. Okay, from this context, we have seen the header and we have seen the partner. Now we need to go over condition tables. So what are all these condition tables? So these are nothing but your condition types for rebate. So here I have a condition like a rebate for customer or settlement customer rebates, or it's a material rebate, or it's an organizational rebate. So like that, we have a n number of rebates. So in this condition contract, what are all the eligible rebates or eligible conditions I can use? So first of all, when I go to the condition contract, okay, so here in this I have two entries. So one is a material based and another one is just number based. So always there should be in your access sequence, just remember, always there should be a number. You can create an n number of accesses, but in each and every access the number should be enabled. So number is nothing but your condition contract number. So without this number, this will not determine at a sales order level. So if I create a condition contract, okay, I have created a condition contract, let's say 1000, and in my condition types or in my condition tables, I have not given the table with the number. Okay, it's not there, number is not there. So what will happen if the number is not there at a sales order level? When I determine or when I use this sales order for the particular customer, so eligible customer is, let's say, 1000, or I can say some customer one. So I have created a sales order with the same customer one. So what system should do? System should find out or fetch if there are any eligible condition contracts for this customer with the, within that validity date. So here in this condition contract, I maintain this for from 16/06/2018. Okay, I will maintain this for 30/06/2018. So within this range, I have maintained this condition contract and I have maintained the customer and condition types I have maintained for, let's say, RBS, REBA. So this is one of the condition type we will discuss. But for example, I just put REBA as my condition type and it contains, so 5% of rebate. So when I go and create a sales order for this customer, by default, system should fetch this 5% into my sales order. This is my condition from this REBA. So to determine this 5% into the sales order, we are maintaining the condition tables with a number. So this REBA will have an access, or we'll have a condition table with a number. This number is nothing but this 1000. Okay. So when I create a sales order for this particular customer, system will go into the backend configuration into the CCM and it will find out for this customer what are all the eligible condition contract types or condition contracts it has, and it will fetch. So if, say for example, if I have a two condition contracts for the customer, so normally we should not create a two within that validity. We should only use only one condition contract. So like for example, what I mean is I have 1000 as one of the customer one of the condition contract with the customer one. Okay, and also I have a 2000 in this, also I have a customer one. So when I create a sales order with same customer, system will not find 1000 and 2000. It will find only 1000, which is the most latest one to be created. At least one, not a latest one. 2000 will not be determined. So if it has anything previously created condition contract, it will determine the first latest one. So that is the reason why we should not maintain multiple contracts for a single customer. So normally we will maintain only one. If the contract is not valid, so then we will delete, or we will invalid this in the first contract and we will extend this to the second contract. Say for example, for this customer, I don't want to give 5%. I want to give 10%. So then in the 2000 contract, it's for 10%. I will go for 2000. So in this, I will, in the eligible partners, I will just remove this range. Okay. So then when I create a sales order for this customer, automatically this one will come. So this is how you need to determine the condition contracts for either it is for 5% or 10%. So what here important point is, when I create a condition contract, so that number, whatever the condition contract number is there, it is also one of the field in your condition areas. So condition table will always contain a number. Okay, so without this number, I cannot go and create anything for this. Okay, even if you create also, it does, system will not determine at a sales order level. So that means what, whether it's a 5% or 10%, you cannot get the value. So that is the reason always in the condition contract table, we need to always have or the condition table with a number. This is one of the main important point. Okay, so then I will go to the SPRO. So we have seen this condition contract maintenance. Now I'm going to the condition contract conditions. Okay, so we have a sales and we have a purchasing. So we are discussing that this CCM is not only specific to your ST, it is also useful for your MM for purchases. Okay, from the seller point of view, seller perspective. So now I will go and define condition tables. Okay, we have RE star. Yeah, this is REST, REBA. These are all my condition contracts. This is for percentage, manual entry. Okay. RB00 can also be used. So these are all the, some of the condition types we use in normally in the real time. REST, RB00, REBA, RBST. Okay, I will give that list. RB00. So this is absolute, this for fixed amount, and REST is for percentage. Okay, so one will be at a percentage level and one will be at a fixed amount level. And remaining all settings are common, only just you know, to know whether it's for absolute amount or whether it is for fixed amount. And since it's a discount, you will be maintaining the condition class as a discount. Okay, and the next is you need to specify it's a condition contract relevancy and copy controls. So I have so many condition types. So REBA, RBST, like n number of rebate documents or rebate conditions I have. So whether all these are relevant for my rebates. So that is a, this is a place where you are maintaining the relevancy. So CC is condition contract relevancy and the copy controls. So in your ECC system, when you create a condition, when you create a rebate agreement, okay, and you maintain that BA00 or BA01 or BA02. These are all my conditions in my ECC. So what you will do in your ECC system, for example, so what I am doing in my ECC system is, in my EC system, so I will tell you the difference. I have a BA00 in my ECC and I have a REST in my S4HANA system. So in ECC system, when I created this condition, I put against this condition a routine call 24. Okay, but here we are not putting any routine. What we are saying is, in ECC, I want this condition to be determined only at a billing document level, and I don't want to see it at a billing at a sales order level. But here, this is completely in contracts with your ECC. In S4HANA system, we are saying, okay, the value will be copied, or value will be determined at a sales order level, and from there, it is relevant for copying. So that is the reason. Here we are enabling this as condition contract relevant, and this is a copy control relevant also. So that means wherever this condition is maintained at a sales order level, it will automatically populate to the delivery and bill. Okay, so this is a condition contract. REST is nothing but this is my condition contract which I am going to create for my rebate processing. So now you just see now. Okay, so this is something which we it's out of scope now because we are discussing it for ECC. So now here I have a REST, and also I can use REBA or I can use RB00. So these are all the three conditions I want to give to the customer. So how system knows that these are all relevant? You will come in the configuration, in this configuration, and you will maintain the copy control and you will maintain the relevancy. Okay, so that means, so first of all, you are saying that, okay, I have three conditions I want to determine. So in this, I will maintain these are all relevant for condition contract, and this is also relevant condition contract. Say like, for example, this is not relevant. So I'm not putting this as a condition contract relevance. These two are eligible for determining at a sales order level. Okay, so but first of all, you should ensure that only these two are coming. So it's wherever you have a n number of condition records, you activated this for condition contract types. So but within these condition contract types, I also have a PR00 and I also have a some PB00. So these are all my pricing processor condition types. I have in my pricing processor PR00, PP00, REST, REBA, and RB00. These are all my condition types in the in your pricing browser. Pricing browser, where do you configure? We will configure in V/08, right? So in that we have a n number of condition types, but whether all are relevant for determining at a sales order level, so that will come normally. It will control in the CC configuration, condition contract configuration. You have to just tell these are all my conditions which I want. So at the sales order level, I will get this value and I will get this value. Okay. So now what we have done. I have a conditions, I have created n number of conditions, and I say these, what are all the relevant conditions I want to activate, or I want to give it at a condition contract level. Now I will go to the WCO here. Okay, I will try to create an entry. Okay, so here just see what is the condition type we have. I will be maintaining at a percentage level, and what is my condition types. You see RGA1 and RES1, we have only two. Okay, now you go to the IMG. Okay, REA1 is not valid here. Okay, so we have REA1, but how system is determining this REA1? So that we need to see. So where, from where this REA1, RES1 is coming? It is not available in the configuration, but somewhere it was maintained. Where it is maintained? It is maintained in the condition assignment to the condition groups. If this is what is your condition group, OS01, and what are all the conditions we have. Now just see, we have a RES1 and we have a REA1 and REBA. So these are all my conditions. Just see RES1, REA1 and REBA. Now I will go to this. Okay, I have a RES1 rebates and REA1. Okay, I have a RES1 and REA1 and REBA. Okay, so I have these three. So what I have did here, or what I have done, I went into the conditions and I activated what are all my rebate conditions, and I just say, okay, these are all relevant for my rebates, and then I have activated this into some group. So you have to create into a group. So these are all activated. So after this, what are all the relevant? I need to create one group, and this group will be having all the conditions which are relevant for rebates. So this group is my group. This I have all the conditions. So here you can put access sequence. So for this RES1, either you can create with only a number, or you can also create with a number and material. Same way REA1 can be created with number or number and material. Same way REBA can be created with number and material. Okay, so this way you are saying the system, okay, I have conditions and I maintain the conditions relevant for rebates, and I maintain what are all my rebate conditions with access sequence. So in your present processor, what you are doing, you are maintaining the present processor. Under the present processor, you will maintain all the condition records or condition types. After that, you will assign this present processor to the sales area and sales document level. But here we are not assigning anything to the sales area, but here we are assigning the conditions to a group, and the group is maintained in the condition contract type. So just see, this is my group. Okay, so now if I go into the condition contract, okay, so OS01 is a group for sales. So whatever the conditions we have assigned into the OS01 will be shown here. Okay, so we have a REA1 and RES1. So you may also get a doubt, like, why REBA is not coming. Okay, why REBA is not coming is because in this we have chosen the number value. So if I choose number and material, then REBA will come. Just imagine. Okay, now see, we have a 3, REA1, REBA and RES1. So why 3 are coming in the configuration? I have maintained the 3 into the condition groups. So this is my condition group, condition type group. In this condition type group, I have these 3 as my conditions. Okay, so I have a RES1, REA1 and REB1, but REB1 is only maintained for number and material access sequence. So that's why it is coming only at an access sequence level, number and material. But if I choose this only at a material level, it is not coming. So now, is it clear for you how the conditions are determining it as condition contract level? Just to recap you, conditions, I have to maintain the conditions, and all these conditions I need to set, these are all relevant for my rebates process. And once I set all these things, I will maintain or I will assign all these things into the condition group, and this condition group is assigned to the condition contract type. So are you following the sequence? So first is, I have a condition table. In the condition table, I will maintain the what are all my access sequence. After this, I will maintain condition types into the groups, and that group is assigned to the condition contract type. So that is a link, condition contract type, from the condition contract type to the groups, groups to the condition types, and condition types to the value, whether it's a percentage or it's a fixed. Are you clear to here? How my value is coming here? So if you are clear to here, so it's very easy to understand the remaining clues. Are you getting till this point, or you still have some confusion? Shall I repeat it again, or
maybe Santosh just recap that the flow,
yeah.
How the.
See, for example, I have a condition contract type. Maybe I will put it here. Okay, so I have a condition contract. A type as SPP1. So this is my condition contract. So in this condition contract, so till now what we entered is, I have a header details. Okay, I will be maintaining the eligible partners. and I will be maintaining the price. So within this, the eligible, the header details will contain the sales organization, purchase organization, and settlement data. So this role, it is just normally you are maintaining. And eligible partners also will contain what are all the eligible partners or eligible customers. So these are all straightforward. There is no much configuration. It's once you know how to do the configuration, this is all much pretty easy. Now I will go to the condition area. So condition area is place where what are all the condition types I want to determine. So I have a 10 repeat conditions. REBA, right? REB1. So like this, I have a 10. Okay, so in these rebates, I want for SPB1, I want to use only 4 or 5. So I don't want this REBA and REB6. So first of all, we need to tell the system, okay, these are all my rebate conditions. And how the system knows this, these are all relevant for condition contracts. So you will be maintaining the CC configuration. You say this is relevant, and this is relevant, and this is relevant, okay, and this is also relevant, this is also relevant. And if you don't want something to be not relevant, you can just put a blank. So now what I'm saying, I have a conditions, few conditions, and all these conditions are relevant for settlement or for CCA module. But when I use my condition contract SPB1, I want only what are all highlighted here in this orange color. Remaining should not be determined. So then what I will do, I will create one group, sales group. In this sales group, I will maintain all this 5. Okay, so this is my group. In this group, I have maintained all the relevant conditions for rebates. Okay, and this group I will attach you to the SPB1. Now, can you correlate? I have a condition contract SPB1. In that, I have assigned the group. The group contains only 5 rebates. Okay, either I can give for all the 5 or I cannot, I don't want to give. But first of all, you know, to activate this as a CC rebate. If this is not active, so that means you cannot, even if you maintain this in the group, it will not be eligible to determine the value. Okay, and if these are all maintained but you are not assigned in the sales group, then also it will not come. So it is a mutually exclusive, mutually relevant. Okay, so without one, and another one cannot be existed. Okay, so now when I use SBB1 as my condition contract type, system will automatically determine these are all the conditions I will be having based on this group. Okay, so this group will contain condition types, and the condition types is normal condition type configuration V/06. There is no change in this.
Santosh, sorry, here you haven't selected REB5 in a relevancy configuration.
Yeah,
right, but you added in a group.
Yeah, then it will not come. Even if I add also, it is not relevant.
Exclusive. That's
should
right.
Be both values should be triggered. If I didn't say this one, so this is not relevant for condition contract. If I didn't add it here in the group, it will not again determine in the sales order. Okay, both are relevant.
Both are, okay, yeah. Okay. Got it.
So now I will come here. I will maintain this. Okay, this is a percentage. Since you are maintaining it for percentage also, I will just put this percentage. say like for example, I will maintain REBA also. Okay, and I put this value as some 10 rupees or 10 euros.
The 10 euros per order or
now we'll come back again 11. Now I'm maintaining this RES1 and this is my material 254. Okay, and calculation type I will put this as a fixed percentage, and this I will put within the range of my contract validity, and rate I will put as a 5%. Okay, so this is one I am going to save. Okay, so now I save this. Now you can see this is a condition record number. This will be shown in the KONE, or now we have a PRCD underscore elements. So this is a value which can be shown in the table level. So what I will do, I will go and create a sales order for this customer and we will see what value will be there. I'm creating a sales order. This is my sales order. Okay, it's a CCM1. Material I will put as 254. Order quantity 1. Okay, I have a pricing error. Okay, it's I'll go to the conditions. I will put PR00 as some 1000. Okay, now I will go to this, I can go to the analysis. Okay, now you just see we have activated this REBA. What we activated RES1, right? Okay, we have activated RES1, but it is not determined. Condition contract number is not there, and number and material. Okay, we have a material, but the contract number is not determining. So why it is not determining? Because we have not released the condition contract. Okay, I will go to WCO. You just go to the status and you can see it is still in the release new mode. We need to release this. Okay, after this you just save. Okay, now I will go to this. I'm not going to save this order. Now go page up and you see condition analysis for this. Oh, just a question. It should be because of the refresh. I will just try now. Yeah, now just see 5% is a value. Okay, so 5% is a RES1 value I have calculated. How the system is calculated? Now I will go to this analysis and I will see in the RES1. This is a condition contract 11, and this is a material we have given. Okay, so even if I have n number of condition contract for the same customer, the system will go and look into the first one, whatever is eligible one or whatever is having within that validity date. Okay, if you, even if you have 3 or 4, okay, it doesn't matter, it will only go and fetch the first one until unless it finds the first one or it the validity date is not within the range, it will not go to the second one. Okay, so this is how the condition contract is to be created and it will determine sales order load. So now if you see here, if you see to the condition contract, so what do you see, do you observe any error message in this, or do you observe any process which it should not come, or which it should not behave like this? Are you able to see?
Yeah.
What is the issue? What I'm trying to say is, so do you see by seeing itself at first glance, can you identify whether the process is correct or not? Means the rebate condition, whether it should behave in the same way or it should behave in differently. By seeing the condition types or by seeing the value, or do you see any change from the standard rebate process?
Any issue?
Okay. So yeah, there is an issue here in this case. I will tell you what is the issue. So before that, first of all, we will just recap our definition. Rebate process is, rebate is a kind of a discount which will be given retrospectively paid out to the customer. Okay, for a certain period. So now here, what we are doing, I am deducting the 5% from the net value, so which should not happen, because if I am deducting the 5% here, so then what is the difference from the rebate to the discount? So here I already gave a discount to the customer, but it will not be paid at the end of the period or at and while doing a settlement. So rebate is nothing but I am just paying to the customer. Here I am just giving a discount here for the customer, but I want to pay this 5% to the customer using the settlement document. So then it will be called as a rebate. If you are doing like this, then it is called as a, it is not a rebate condition. Okay, it is normal discount.
On sales document, it's only the static condition, not the. It should
no, but it is calculating. It is paying a discount as a 5% and shows 95 is my value. So yeah, here normally rebate will be shown as a 5%. But it will not deduct from your net value. It should not deduct. So that is the meaning of rebate.
Okay. It's actually become like a discount.
Yeah. Now it is acting as a discount. So where is the issue? So issue is either it should be in your present closure or it should be somewhere in the routine.
Santosh, in such cases, actually we need to put some accruals, right? For this kind of a rebate condition type should be accrual. So
Yeah,
in that
that is,
case,
yeah, that will be there. Accruals will be there. But first of all, the value should not deduct. So then what is the issue here is, in my pricing procedure, I will just go to the pricing procedure and see what is maintained there. Okay, this is my standard pricing procedure. RES1, I will just find out my bid condition. Okay, so this I am putting this as a 164 written. We will see what is there for others. Okay, you just see here, just calculating minus one. It's from the base value, this value is getting calculated. Okay, so that is the reason. I will just change it to 163.
Santosh, actually we'll give the volume of the business, right? Suppose if you do, a customer has to get rebate only 5% if it touches $10,000 per month or per annum 1 lakh. So actually we will give like that, right? So when we are maintaining the condition record for the rebates, but here I didn't find that thing. Actually, in the contract type, did you maintain such thing when you're creating condition contract?
No, contract we will not maintain. So, say for example, you want to give a rebate only if the sales order is created or only the sales order reaches or places for 1,000 as a net or 1,000 as the total gross value. So, that is what you are saying.
Yeah.
So,
that is how you have to do, right? In the volume of the business for quarterly or per annum, if you do this much business, you will get this 5% rebate. Till then, it will be accrued. And finally, once you reach that 100% of the volume of the business, then only that a rebate has to be passed to the customer through a settlement.
That is common. That is what we are creating in the WCO, in my business volume. So the business volume, the value field, what we entered here, business volume, you are saying this. This business volume, you are saying, okay, what is your total business volume on which you want to create? So here I maintain this for this customer and for this sales area. And if I want to create anything, I can just go and maintain as per my requirement. So currently it is only for customer base and sales area basis. So if you say I want based on the volume base also, like until unless the customer is customer sales volume is reaches to $10,000, I should not release the settlement. So this you can maintain in the business volume data. That I will show you. We have not yet covered till that point. Okay, now I'm into the 163. I just save this. Okay, now you just see RES1, it is showing as a 5%, but it is not calculated any value. This value will be accrued to the sales settlement process, to the settlement process. Okay, so this is how the rebate should be calculated.
Is there any transaction we can see that, you know, these accruals, how much is the...
No, during the settlement only we can see. So at the time when we are doing the settlement process, we can see. See, another thing is in your V/08, you need to maintain the accrual conditions. So that is same. Standard ECC also you are doing it. You will maintain the ERA, ER accruals. So that value will be shown there into the accruals. And when you are trying to do a settlement, we will see what are all my rebate, or what is the total rebate amount I need to settle to the customer.
Okay.
So what does that 163 says, that requirement routine?
163 says the value will be shown as a 0 here. The rebate value will be shown as a 0 and it will not detect anything from this condition. But if I activate accruals for this, this 5% will be activated to accruals, and during a settlement. So let's say, for example, I have created a settlement on, I want to do a settlement on before the end of the month. At that settlement time, system will find out what are all the rebate value it identifies for this particular customer, and it will bring into settlement. So when I do a settlement, a credit memo will be generated to the customer. Okay. So this is how the rebate settlement with the condition contract, sales order level, how it is determined. So now we have to see how the billing value will come. So that means how a settlement will be created into this. So for this, maybe we need to proceed with the sales order, delivery and billing document, and later on we need to create a settlement.
So in ECC we are creating an agreement, here we are creating a condition contract. That is the only difference I'm seeing.
The only difference is condition contract, but there is agreement, but that agreement is specific to that customer, right? If I want to create agreement with for a supplier who is also a customer for me, so then I need to create another settlement, rebate agreement. And
okay. So but before that we have a check, like for not all the customers are relevant for rebates, right? Only few customers are relevant for rebate.
That check is not there. So we have a you remember that in the billing document level, maybe all the billing documents are not relevant for this. So for this, yeah, in ECC we have a VO FA setting.
Yeah, in the billing document, sales organization level and customer level, the rebate will be there, activation. Yeah. Okay.
Correct. But so that relevant for rebate. So this sales field will be there, and at a sales organization level, it is in SC16 TV KO. So it is also relevant for rebate.
Yeah, rebate process active.
Okay, rebate processing active. And that is customer master XG01 we have. But now in the customer master we don't have. We will be having it at rebate processing level. So I will just check this. That's a business partner level. Those changes are same. So at us activating the sales order level, delivery, billing level and sales order level. So those will be, anyhow, we are going to activate. So but along with that one, instead of adding it a sales at a customer level, we are doing it at a business partner level.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I will go to the customer.
Billing tab, I think should be in billing.
No, it will be here only.
For settlement management here, okay.
Okay, so this is a field which we need to activate for a business partner. And along with that one, we need to maintain the eligible partners. Okay, so say for example, this customer is also acting as my vendor. So I want to give a rebate for that vendor also. So then in that case, it's not required for you to create multiple rebate agreements. It's only one condition contract which we can create, and we need to activate it for purchase organization. Okay, automatically when I create a PO with this particular business partner, the value amount will be coming over there, or the condition contract will be determined over there. So this is the data redundancies are completely removed, and the lock entry is also removed, and VBox, which is nothing but your multiple duplicate entries will be there in the VBox. So that also will be stopped. So when I create the rebate agreement, the relevant billing documents will be seen in the VBox table. But here we don't have any VBox updates, so everything will be updated into the WCO tables. Okay, so that is a difference line here. Only the process wise it's changing. So we have a rebate agreement, and a rebate agreement will be created. But the rebate, using a rebate agreement, we are going to create a settlement. But here in this case, we have a sales order also in between. Okay, so that is another difference.
But here also the main document for settlement you are treating as invoice or a sales order?
Invoice only, not sales order.
But what is the use by putting that condition type in the sales order? In that case, suppose if I create a sales order for rebate and after that I canceled it, so then it is not used, right? So but finally, once you have done the invoice only, the invoice document is only relevant for rebates, right? Otherwise, the sales order is nowhere relevant for rebates, because it is a statistical document. Any moment you can cancel it.
Yeah, we can cancel it, but the copy controls we are maintaining in the condition rebate processing, the settlement management, where we say it is relevant for rebate calculation and it also comes into the billing document. Okay, whenever
so
there is a billing document,
the what is the advantage to put like that? So what is the reason behind that one? I'm just thinking. So because finally at the end of the day, we want to see all the invoices need to be settled, right? But not the sales order. But what is the logic to put in the sales order of that rebate condition type? That's what I'm thinking.
So logic is your sales volume. So let's whatever business volume you said previously, I want 1,000 is the sales volume of the customer. So if he places a sales orders with 1,000 value, so then only the rebate should be relevant. In your ECC, we are putting this, we are controlling this using some routines. Either 24 or 25 we are putting, but here it's not like a routine control, it is a transaction control. Okay, so we are not putting any code over there. It's such a way to identify, okay, I have 1,000 sales orders. Okay, even if you cancel the sales order also, maybe tomorrow, say for example, I have 3 sales orders. Okay, sales order 1. Okay, this value is 500. Okay, and the second sales order, this value is 300. And third sales order, this value is 200. So now the system, we are telling the system, okay, based on the sales volume, if the customer sales order is reached to 1,000, so then only the rebate we are going to settle it. So tomorrow all the sales orders are processed till billing document. So we have a billing document for this. Okay, so we have a billing document for this, and this billing document, instead of creating a billing document, this was somehow it was they put rejection. So that means now what is the sales volume? It is only 700, right? So until unless I have a 1,000, I will not process the rebate. When I do a rebate settlement, I'm just entering the customer number and system will try to find out what are all the sales order which are populated for this condition contract. Then that will find out how many sales volume or what is the volume of a sales the customer has placed. Billing document is something where your accruals is getting captured, but the sales volume I can know only through the sales order level, right? It's not at a billing value level. So we have a conditions saying if customer places 1,000 sales volume or 1,000 quantity of material, then only I want to give a rebate. So that will be placed only based on the sales order. Okay, it's one of the criteria, but currently what we are doing is we are using this through a routine. We are controlling this through a routine. And we are assigning this routine to the rebate condition type. So instead of calculating using the routine, we can control this at a process level. So that is the advantage. Okay, is it clear?
Okay.
So tomorrow we will see the settlement, how the settlement will happen, and we will run the full cycle from the condition contract, sales orders, deliveries, billing and settlement.
Okay. Thank you, Santosh.
Thank you. Thank you, Murthy. Thank you, Roman.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, Jagesh.